Applications generate a large amount of data in the form of documents, logs, and metrics to provide services to end users. Handling this ever-growing trove of data in a way that makes it available for insights, yet still economically viable, becomes a core challenge for the modern enterprise. MinIO includes robust object lifecycle management to help manage this challenge, no matter what scale it reaches. When working with object lifecycle management, you essentially have two options. The first option is to expire the object. This simply deletes it. Let's imagine a security audit application. The application accepts new logs and metrics for processing. However, this original data doesn't need to be kept in MinIO indefinitely once the processing is completed. In this use case, expiring the data makes sense, as it keeps the amount of data awaiting processing low, saving storage space. The second option is to transition the object, which moves it to a different cluster. This allows you to seamlessly retain your data in a cost-effective manner by using two tiers. Let's call our two tiers hot and warm. After some time, the bucket will move the object to the warm tier. But the object is still accessible via the hot tier. The hot tier maintains a link to the warm tier where the object is stored. This means tiering is transparent to the application, independent of where the objects are stored. The main reason for this tiering is to keep rarely accessed objects available long-term on the warm tier, which generally has a huge amount of slower storage, freeing up space on your hot tier for the more active objects, which uses faster storage. Think about keeping database snapshots, for instance. The more recent snapshots will be used more frequently to do work on fresh data. But we may need to keep years of data available for auditing purposes, even though those audits are far less frequent. So, after some time, it makes sense to move stale data to the slower tier, but we still want to keep the data available. Of course, eventually this data will no longer be useful, at which point we could also expire it, keeping our warm tier storage clean. And this is exactly why MinIO supports object lifecycle management.